Let's be perfectly clear, running a 10K in 45 minutes is fast. That performance puts you in the top 5% of all recreational runners. You are, by definition, a serious trained athlete. But breaking 40 minutes? That's a different sport entirely, and that is 10 kilometers back-to-back at a pace of 4 minutes per kilometer. That's 6 minutes and 26 seconds per mile for 6 straight miles. Statistics show that less than 1% of the running population will ever achieve this. Why? Why is the jump from 45 to 40 so much harder than the jump from 50 to 45? It's not just 5 more minutes, it's a physiological wall. Most runners fail here because they believe the strategy that got them to 45 minutes will, if they just try harder, get them to 39. They are wrong. Trying harder is the problem. Running a sub 45 10K is a challenge of fitness. Running a sub 40 10K is a challenge of physiology. The truth is, your body is actively fighting you. To break this barrier, you have to stop training like an amateur and start training like a scientist. You need to stop just running and start manipulating the 4 critical pillars of endurance. In this masterclass, we will scientifically dissect those 4 pillars. This is not guesswork. This is the blueprint. This is how you join the 1% club. Pillar 1. The engine, VO2 max. The first pillar is your aerobic engine. We call this your VO2 max. Think of VO2 max as the size of your engine. Scientifically, it is the maximum volume of oxygen your body can uptake, transport, and utilize during 1 minute of maximal exercise. It's measured in milliliters of oxygen per kilogram of body weight per minute. A sub 45 minute runner might have a good VO2 max, perhaps in the 50 to 55 milliliters per kilogram per minute range. But to hold a 4 kilometers per hour pace, you are operating at an intensity that demands a bigger engine. You need to be pushing into the 58 to 65 plus range. How do you build a bigger engine? You can't just run more. You have to run harder, with surgical precision. This is where classic VO2 max intervals come in. These are not your comfortable tempo runs. These are workouts designed to do one thing, force your cardiovascular system to its absolute limit, demanding more oxygen than you can currently supply. A staple workout in a sub 40 plan looks like this. 10 to 12 repetitions of 400 meters at your target, 345 to 355 kilometers per hour pace. That's your 5K race pace, or faster. You take a controlled 200 meter jog or 60 second standing rest, and you go again. Why this specific pain? Because these short, intense bursts with minimal rest force your heart to become a more powerful pump. They don't give your heart rate time to fully recover. Your heart's stroke volume, the amount of blood it pumps per beat, is forced to increase. The long-term adaptation? Your body says, I cannot handle this stress. I must adapt. So it builds a bigger engine. It creates more mitochondria, the energy factories in your muscle cells. It builds a denser capillary network to deliver that oxygenated blood. You are literally replumbing your entire system. This is non-negotiable. Pillar 2, the gearbox, lactate threshold LT2. This is the most important pillar, and it's the one most runners completely misunderstand. If you think VO2 max is the key to your 10K, you're wrong. It's the prerequisite. The single greatest predictor of your 10K performance is your lactate threshold, or LT2. If VO2 max is the size of your engine, your LT2 is your gearbox. It determines how much of that engine's power you can actually use before you redline. Let's bust a myth. Lactate is not your enemy. It is not a waste product that makes your legs burn. That is outdated. 1980s science. Lactate is high octane fuel. It's a byproduct of burning glucose, and your body is brilliant at shuttling it back to the mitochondria to be reused as energy. The burn you feel is the buildup of hydrogen ions, acidosis, which occurs as a byproduct of rapid glucose breakdown. Your lactate threshold, LT2, is the specific intensity, that heart rate, that pace, where your body's ability to produce lactate exceeds its ability to clear and reuse it. For a sub-45 runner, this redline pace might be 4 minutes, 25 seconds per kilometer. If they try to run at 4 kilometers per hour, they cross that threshold. Acidosis builds up rapidly, their breathing goes haywire, and they are forced to slow down within minutes. To run a sub-40, your LT2 must be faster than 4 minutes per kilometer. You need to be able to run the entire race just below your red line. How do we raise this threshold? We train at it. This is the famous tempo run, or threshold run. This is the bread and butter of your sub 40 plan. We're talking about 30 to 40 minutes of sustained running at your current LT2 pace, around 4:05 to 4:015 per kilometer. This workout is brutally uncomfortable. It's not a sprint, but it's not a jog. It's what we call comfortably hard. It teaches your body at a cellular level to become more efficient at clearing lactate. It trains your type 1 and type 2, a muscle fibers, to get better at using lactate as fuel. You are quite literally teaching your body to tolerate a faster pace for longer. This is the secret sauce, pillar 3, the foundation, aerobic base. You cannot build a skyscraper on a foundation of sand. All the high-intensity work from pillars 1 and 2 is useless if your body breaks down or lacks fundamental endurance. The hard truth, you cannot hack your way to a sub 40-10K by just doing 2 hard workouts a week. You need a foundation. That foundation is built with mileage. To break this barrier, you need to be consistently running 60 to 70 kilometers per week. That's 37 to 43 miles, spread over 5 or 6 days. Why? Because 80% of this mileage should be easy running. This easy running is where the real aerobic adaptations happen. This is where you build those type 1 slow twitch muscle fibers, the fatigue-resistant workhorses of endurance. This low-intensity work is what teaches your body metabolic flexibility. It trains your body to become incredibly efficient at beta oxidation, the process of burning your body's fat stores for fuel. Why does that matter for a short 10K race? Because your body can only store about 90 minutes of glycogen, carbohydrate fuel. Even in a 40-minute race, if you are metabolically inefficient, you will burn through that glycogen too quickly. By training your body to burn fat for fuel, you spare that high-octane glycogen for the final brutal 3 kilometers of the race. Your long runs, typically 18 to 20 kilometers, are not just about time on feet. They are a systemic stressor that builds capillary density and trains your body to resist fatigue. This is your insurance policy for the last mile. Pillar 4, the armor, economy, and strength. The final pillar is the one most runners ignore. Running economy. Running economy is your fuel efficiency. It's how much oxygen you consume to maintain a given pace. Imagine two runners. Both have an identical VO₂ max of 60. Runner A has poor economy. At 4 kilometers per hour pace, he uses 90% of his VO₂ max. He's redlining. Runner B has great economy. At 4 kilometers per hour pace, she only uses 80% of her VO₂ max. She is running in control. Runner B will beat runner A every single time. How do you improve this? You get stronger. This is not about bigger muscles, it's about better ones. This is about neuromuscular efficiency. Your sub-40 plan must include heavy lifts 2 days a week, squats, deadlifts, lunges. Heavy lifting, 3 to 5 sets of 5 to 8 reps, doesn't just build muscle. It trains your brain to recruit more muscle fibers with every single step. Plyometrics, box jump, pogo hops. These build stiffness in your Achilles and calf muscles. A stiff tendon is like a pogo stick. It stores and returns more energy from the ground, propelling you forward for 3. Strides and hill sprints. These are short, 100-meter bursts of speed. They are not for fitness. They are for form. They teach your body what it feels like to run fast and efficiently, improving your cadence and reducing your ground contact time. This strength work is your armor. It's what makes the 4 kilometers per hour pace feel easier, and more importantly, it's what prevents the injuries that 60 to 70 kilometer weeks will inevitably cause if you are weak. The conclusion, the 1% formula. Breaking 40 minutes is not about one thing. It's not the intervals, it's not the tempos, it's not the long runs. It's the synergy of all 4 pillars executed with precision week after week for 9 to 12 months. It requires a plan that isn't just a generic PDF. It needs to be your plan. Your 400-meter interval pace is not the same as someone else's. Your threshold pace, your LT2, is unique to your physiology. This is where science meets practice. Our man-to-man coaching is designed for this exact challenge. I am Coach Dimitris, MSc in Sports Science, and this is my commitment. We don't just send you a PDF. We analyze your data from your Garmin or Coros. We identify your specific VO2 max and LT2 zones. We design your personal plan to attack your specific weaknesses. Using special software, we send the workouts, the 12 by 400 seconds, the 30-minute tempos, directly to your watch. Every morning, you wake up and know exactly what you have to do. And the most important part, we have unlimited chatting via WhatsApp or Viber. Did you miss a workout? Do you feel a pain? We are there daily to make the necessary adjustments. If you are ready to stop guessing and start training with a scientific plan, send me a message today. Positions are limited to ensure that personal one-on-one contact. Send me an email or a message on WhatsApp. Let's discuss your 45-minute personal best, and let's design the plan that gets you to 39. Your running journey, powered by science.